Most apps use some type of networking in their code. And implementing a networking connectivity monitor doesn't require a lot of code, and it can be the difference between a happy and a frustrated user. So you need to handle network connection issues gracefully. Let's find out how you too can have a network monitor in your SwiftUI app. Before we dive into how to create a networking layer or network manager for your SwiftUI applications, let me remind you about DevFactory, a 6-minute Zoom call with me. If you have any questions about your application or you just want to learn SwiftUI, go ahead and check it out. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. So let's dive into our code. Today I have prepared a demo project and basically it just has a home view, a known network view, and of course the content view is just unmodified. So why do we need this? Well, our application will be actually our home view. Currently it's just an image with a text of hello world. And if we are running out of connectivity, then the known network view should be displayed. A Wi-Fi image with a slash and some text with that. Okay, so if I just build it run right now, you will see that all we have is our content view with the globe and the hello world. Let's just see that it's just going okay. And we are going to build out a network monitor. And after that, we just test it out and we are going to create a Swift package for that so you too can use it. Okay, so there we go. We have our hello world. So basically, this is what I do when I'm building out Swift packages. I create a builder for XCODE project for it, and then I'll just start building out. So just add everything right over here under the content view, and because anyway, I'm going to move this out into a Swift package. So what we need to do is just import the network framework, because that is what we are going to use to have our network monitor. So we are having an import on the network. By the way, let me just move this out of the way so we can see it quite easily. We're going to create a class, an observable object actually, that will be our network monitor, and that will be an observable object. And this observable object pops up because we already have SwiftUI imported. So this will be really important when we are actually it's observable object. This will be really important when we are creating the Swift package. Okay, so right over here, we're just going to have a few properties and an initializer. It will be really, really straightforward. Once you just type this out, you will say, okay, was this just easy as it is? Yes, it's that easy. Okay, so let's create a private let, and that will be an NW. Path monitor that comes from the network framework. Secondly, I want to create a worker queue, and that will be a dispatch queue with the label of monitor. There we go. And finally, we want to have access to the isConnected boolean, so we can use that easily in our SwiftUI views. So var equals, and the default value should be false. Okay, so we are assuming there is no internet connection. Let's create our initializer. So that's our initializer right over there. Now we want to catch the path update handler of our network monitor. So we just go path update handler equals and two parentheses, and we're going to get back here a path in. Okay, and now we can know when the path is being updated if we are connected or not. So we are going to change the isConnected accordingly. So if the path.status, there we go, .status equals to dot, and as you can see, we have unsatisfied, satisfied, requires connection. We just go is with it's a satisfied. So isConnected will be true if the path status is satisfied. Otherwise, it will be false. And after that, because we do need to update our views, we're going to run, this is inside an init, so we need to run an object with change.send. So that will be a task and a wait. We're doing this on the main actor, so we can add this to our views. And then we are going to, well, let me just move this body. So I don't really like that type of completion, and then we just go self dot object will change dot send. There we go, two parentheses. After we've done this, we want to start our worker queue. So network monitor.start our queue, our worker queue. And believe it or not, that's it. Now we have, by the way, let's just see what's going on right over here. So we want to move this out of the way. So after we set up our handler, we want to start our network monitor with that queue. Okay, so now we have access to the is connected. So how are we going to use that? Well, it couldn't be simpler. First of all, we want to use this in the content view. So we want to set this up. We go into the app file. I usually do all of these state objects on the app file. So private state object, and that will be our network monitor. And network monitor, let's just initialize that. And after that, we just set that as an environment object. Sorry, not just environment, but environment object. So now that we have our environment object set up, we can access it inside the content view. So let me just move that out of the way. So private environment object, let's just go private environment object of network monitor of type network monitor. Okay, so now that we have this, we can just safely remove this VStack and go. If the network monitor dot is connected, then we're going to present some view. Otherwise, we are going to present another view. So if we are connected, we are just going to present our home view. Otherwise, we are going to present our no network view. And that's it. So let's just build it run and see. Currently, I'm connected to Wi-Fi, so it will just say hello world with the Wi-Fi. So let's just disconnect right over here. Let's just disconnect. And of course, this will take a little bit of time to just adapt itself because we are in the simulator. If you are just going to do this on your device, it will be a-okay. Let's just build and run again. There we go. Network connection seems to be offline. Please check your connectivity. Let me just double check if I'm just going to allow our network. There we go. Now we have connection, so it will just go to the actual home view. Okay, this is fine and dandy, but this network monitor now is inside our content view file. So let's create a Swift package for our network monitor so we can reuse it in all of our projects. So what I'm going to do is just go under Xcode, go file, new, and then a package. I know you didn't see that, but file, new, and package. So the library, what I'm going to create is the network monitor. Okay, so that is our network monitor, and let me just drop it somewhere safe on my computer. So I'm making sure that we have source control checked, and let's create that. Okay, so let me just resize this so we can see it better. There we go. And let's do a little bit of cleanup. That's what I always do. Let's just remove the test, because we don't need that. We have our sources, a network monitor, and we have our network monitor. So what I'm going to do, just switch back right over here, and let me just copy all of this out and then paste it in to our network monitor file. So I'm going to add that in there. So one thing that I need to add is make this class public, because otherwise it will be internal to our Swift package, so it will not be available on all of our other projects. And as I told you, we still also have to import SwiftUI, because observable object is needed. So public is going to be also our is connected variable and also our initializer. So let's hit Command B, let's see. What do we have? Yes, it's macOS, so I just need to switch to any iOS device and hit Command B again. So let's just wait for that. What's going on? Observable object. Okay, it needs to be available for iOS 13 or later. So for that, I'm going to tweak our package. So what we are going to do is just add an availability for iOS whatever. And I'm just going to paste that in there. iOS 13 is required for this. So let's hit Command B again so we can see that everything is okay. Let's just wait for that. I think we just, yes, it's building again, and it just needs to recognize that the package has been updated. Okay, so it's done. So we have our package. So what do we have to do? Well, we have to create an actual local. So let's just go under repositories. Let's select our main, and let's create a new remote. So network monitor, that's fine by me. Let's select our GitHub account. It will be public. By the way, you can just use this if you want to. You can just click on create there. And then I want to go source control commit. And this will be our first commit. So first commit, let's push to remote. And then let's commit all of these three files and push. Now that we have that, we could just jump to definition and, we are going to do in just a second. But before that, I want to tag this. Let's just tag this to 0.0.1. Let's create that. And under source control, push that tag also. So make sure that you select include tags right over there. And let's just push that up. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just go and select view on GitHub. And there we go. We have our network monitor. If you just jump right over there, here it is. So what I want to do is just go under code because I already have one tag. I'm just going to copy out the HTTPS and let's just go back to our branches. Oh, by the way, I just realized that you didn't see that much right over here. But most probably it was self-explanatory. So what I'm going to do is instead of using, let me just go back to our, I'm going to actually comment this out after I am going to add in our Swift package. So let's just go there, project, package dependencies, click on the plus, and let's just add that in there. Just wait for that, up to next major version, that's perfectly fine. Let's add our package, this will take just a second. Let's click on add package, and there we go, we have our network monitor. Now, under content view, now I can just simply just comment this out, and then what I have to do is just import our network monitor. There we go, network monitor. And also right over here, we want to import our network monitor because this is where we are setting it up. And basically that should be it. Fingers crossed that I don't have to do any tweaks or fixes right over here. Build has succeeded, that's always a good sign. And let's see how this actually works on the iPhone. There we go, let's just wait for that. If you recall, I'm already on a connected Wi-Fi, so let's see if it's just going to go there. Yes, no network connection. So if I just put that back, let's just wait for a connection. And there we go, we have our Hello World with the connectivity. Now, if you did like this project, make sure that you also check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. where you can meet me on a 16-minute Zoom call where I can teach you SwiftUI or I can take a look at some bugs in your code. Now, this is a paid service. And if you want to make sure that you are also going to get paid as a developer, make sure to check out this video right over here.